Hi, my name is Eddie Jackson Jr., and this is Real True Street Crime. I want to tell you all a little something so you'll know something. For all you snitch niggas, so you all will know, here's a fatal mistake Reggie Harding made. When you a snitch nigga, and you turn state's evidence against a brother, when he got a good attorney, his attorney got to fight the case, so the government gives him a list of all the people who slated to testify against him and everybody who done turned any kind of state's evidence, any kind of evidence against you, any statements wrote against you, they show it to your lawyer and your lawyer say, Reggie Harding is finna testify against you and he said, you were so and so and so and so. Understand the fatal mistake Reggie Harding made. He thought Jeezy didn't know that he had snitched on him and that he was going to testify against him in his trial upcoming. Understand that he made a fatal mistake in being a snitch and a rat that he didn't realize Jeezy knew it. So when he's sitting up there in the house, Jeezy is already, before he get back to the house, he didn't park his truck in front of the house. Jeezy has the transcripts from the trial right in his hand, telling him what Reggie Harding has said about him and what Reggie Harding is doing, that he is the informant against him. When you go to court, there is a record of all that, and it don't get thrown away. So if you turn state's evidence, it's a record of it always. And understand the fatal mistake Reggie Harding made. He's finna tell on Jeezy, he's been told on Jeezy, he's slated to testify against Jeezy when the trial come up. Jeezy gets the witness list against him. Everybody and all the evidence against him, they have to give it to you. Sometimes they hold off and try to wait a little longer, and sometimes they just produce it. These are the witnesses testifying against you, and you get to hear every witness who testifying against you and who's supposed to testify against you. You see every statement they made saying anything about you. Don't ever forget that when you a rap nigga. When you know you just snitched on that man, don't sit there and at the table playing cards talking about Jeezy, that's my man. As soon as Mike opened the door, he walk in and blow your head off. Look you in your eyes as a man. Jeezy walked in the house. Reg is sitting at the table playing cards. Jeezy walked. Everybody is looking at this. Look at Reg eye to eye. Everybody is sitting at the table playing cards. He looked Reg in his eye to eye, man to man, reaching his waist and blow Reg's head off. He wanted him to know when he looked him in his eyes, I know you telling on me, nigga. I know you snitching on me. He looked that man in his eyes and knocked him out that chair. That is how he killed Reg in front of six witnesses watching this. A house full of people watching this. There is no way possible he think he gonna get away with this. It's impossible when you kill a man in front of six witnesses. Just that blank. Mike opened the door. He walked in, looked Reg in the eye, out of eye, as to say, nigga, I know you snitching on me. You a rat ass nigga. And pulled out his motherfucking pistol and killed that man dead right in front of everybody in the house watching. So when you a snitch nigga and you know you done snitched on Jeezy, Jeezy is the last nigga when Mike said, it's Jeezy at the door. He on the door to kill you. He knocking on the door just to kill you. He don't care in front of whoever watching. And that's what he did. And he sat there talking about, Jeezy, that's my man. And he walked right in there and knocked that man down. Killed him dead. So when you a rat ass nigga, and you know you done told on a nigga, and you think he don't know, and his lawyers, and he fighting the case, he know everybody who done said anything about him. So what you did in the dark has came to the light, and he know. So now he know. He walk in there and kill that brother. I'm just giving all you rats information. When you done snitched on a nigga and think you don't know, don't let him come around you, because he might know, and he might be coming around you just to take care of your ass. Understand that. I'm just telling you how the game goes. Understand, when you a rat, after the feds get through with you, they feed you to the brothers you told on. Don't ever forget that. After the feds get through with you, or the state, or whichever law enforcement agency you did all that for, look at White Boy Rick. When they got through using him up as a little young kid, threw him in jail for 30-something years. After they got through using White Boy Rick up to be an informant and do all that dirty work for them, trying to catch the mayor up, threw him in the jail for the next 30-some-odd years. So remember this. After they use you up, they ain't got no love for you. They gonna feed you to the dogs. Subscribe, share, and like. Or they gonna feed you to the wolves. Whichever statement you like. They gonna feed you to the dogs, or they gonna feed you to the wolves. Subscribe, share, and like. This is Real True Street Crime. Just giving you all some real helpful information if you that snitch type of nigga. And think a nigga don't know, you snitching. Once he see the evidence and the people slated to testify against him, he see everything, every word you done blew out your mouth. He's sitting there thinking he don't know and lost his life. Subscribe, share, and like. Simmons Law. Check her out, and she was definitely help you out. I'm even trying to give you snitch niggas a little game. Don't think a nigga don't know you snitch. When a nigga gets your file, the case number, he know everything you said. Just like that case file I got on my father. Everything George Blair did and said is right here in black and white. And it will be right here in black and white for life. Once they make up these transcripts and you a snitch, it don't ever go away. This is what it looked like 30 or 40 years later. George Blair brought the informant into Hubbard. And to my father, George Blair is the man who brought the snitch into my father at Hubble. It's in the book, in the whole case, everything. This is what a transcript looked like. And when a nigga get his hands on this, he know who told and who didn't. Subscribe, share, and like. I'm just telling you about rat-ass niggas, what you can't disappear. What's in print and what the government print and print is going to be there. So when you a rat, you a rat. 50 years later, you still a rat. It's right there in black and white. 1977. It's 2021. They both dead and gone, but still in print. George Blair's a rat. Subscribe, share, and like. This is Eddie Jackson Jr. telling you, check out Simmons Law. Check her out and she will definitely help you out. Jelani's Tasting Table, world-class chef, straight out of Baker's Culinary College. Try one of them 420-style turkeys today. Top-tier cuts, 313 Soup Can. Coney Island Chronicles is Coney Island Tony. Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, all over the place. Coney Island Chronicles. And Big Boss Fam, Courtney Brown Jr., just for you. Got to check him out also on Motown Mafia Podcast on Spotify. That's Courtney Brown Jr. too. Subscribe, share, and like. And this is Real True Street Crimes. Why lie when the real true street crime will do? Subscribe, share, and like. And thank you to everybody who takes 1 minute, 1 second, 1 hour out of their day to view me. You humble me in every way. And in the words of Big Bear Cola, the fat man, check out Clarence and Metcalf, loud delivery, straight out of Highland Park, Michigan. Get you some of them 420 style gummy bears, or perhaps just that loud. Clarence and Metcalf, loud delivery. Two loud brothers, straight out of Highland Park, Michigan. And as I say to you before, Why Lie right here on Red Dot Red Shoes on YouTube. Real True Street Crime, Eddie Jackson Jr. for you. Why Lie when the real true street crime will do? Why Lie when the real true street crime will do? Subscribe, share, and like. And by all means, go over there and check out Motown Mafia Podcast on Spotify. And while you on Spotify, check out Crime Town, Kingpin's Kids. We got Ryan Gill Valley narrating that one on Crime Town, Kingpin's Kids on Spotify. Check it out today. And in the words of the Fat Man, Big Bear Cola, the Magic Fat Man, Mr. President, I'm going to be seeing a lot of you all. Subscribe, share, and like, and have a happy, happy, happy holiday season from us here on Real True Street Crime YouTube, Red Dot Red Shoes. Thank you. Subscribe, share, and like, and thank you once again. I'm out. From Real True Street Crime on YouTube, Red Dot Red Shoes, Eddie Jackson Jr., just for you. Peace out.